Mr. Zhirinovski, it's your sixth run. Aren't you bored at this point?
How can something like that be boring? Do you get bored interviewing people? It's work. The most responsible, prestigious, and worthwhile work there is. It's like sport. You've got to be in it to win it.
You said that Russia needs an elected monarchy. So are you saying you want Russia to be ruled by a czar that goes by the name of Vladimir Zhirinovski?
No, but Russia achieved a tremendous amount as a monarchy. We should have kept the monarchy, just like Great Britain, Denmark, Holland, Sweden and Norway. But as an alternative, we could elect a monarch now and change our country's name to the Russian Empire. The president would then be called Supreme Ruler.
As a candidate, foreign relations can't be an afterthought. Russia has come to a dead end in Ukraine. What are the next steps that need to be taken?
One way or the other, Ukraine will collapse. Poland will take the western part, Hungary the Carpathian Mountains, Romania will take Bukovina and Bessarabia, and we'll take the whole of Novorossiya. Ukraine has no future.
I can't imagine Ukraine welcoming those statements. What needs to be done to improve relations?
Nothing. There's an anti-Russian regime in control there, and that's the point.
So you think Ukraine is to blame for everything and not Putin's politics?
Ukraine is to blame with its anti-Russian, pro-Western and unconstitutional forces. The Ukrainians will crack and we'll have to build them up again. The Donbass, Luhansk and other regions.
The West has punished Russia for the illegal annexation of Crimea. So is the Cold War back? And if so, what needs to be done?
I like the situation we have today. The sanctions are strengthening our domestic economy.
Turning to America, when President Trump won, you drank champagne in the Duma in celebration. But then relations with the U.S. worsened. Ties were better during the Obama administration. Did you celebrate too soon?
We celebrated Trump's victory. I predicted it. And so I just celebrated my own correct prediction. Trump won. That was the point. It's a good thing he hasn't improved relations. Where would all of these concessions have gotten us?
Are you saying the worse the better?
It's better when the West regards us as an enemy and restricts us everywhere. Sanctions, sanctions, and more sanctions. That's when we rise up and grow faster.
You are the first presidential candidate I've met who wants his country punished.
I'm not talking about punishment. Rather that the West isn't capable of anything else, and that's its mistake. But it's advantageous for Russia. If the West were to treat us the same way as Ukraine, working together with the EU, the Schengen Agreement, we would have softened a long time ago, accepted everything, and been degraded. Instead, we're getting stronger, and that will help us destroy the West so it doesn't interfere with us.
So you want to destroy the West?
Of course. It's interfering with humanity, America, Germany.
Yeah, but how is Germany harming humanity? How is Germany harming Russia?
It's ruling over Europe. But why?
But Germany is Russia's most important economic partner.
We don't need it. Don't buy from us, and we won't buy from you. If you didn't buy our gas, we'd have more gas pipes. And if you didn't buy our oil, it would be cheaper for us.
March 18th, 8 p.m., the election result should be clear at that point. What can Russia expect at the end of this election day?
I could win, and the next morning the entire country, all 150 million people, will pour into the streets with a smile on their face and rejoice. All sanctions will end after 2 to 3 months. Europeans and Americans will toe the line. I'll take the world to the brink of war. I'll say, do what I say or go hide in a bunker.
Sounds like a great dictator.
Why? Why do you want to interfere with us? We don't interfere with you. Why do you want to say how we Russians should live? Crimea is Russian territory. Russians live there. Russians also live in Donbass. We gave you Germans the chance to unify. And what did you pay us for the privilege? 10 times less than you should have. Europe should be trembling. Even if I don't win on March 18th, the regime in Russia will force you to stop trying to teach us about life. We Russians won't be ordered about by you.
Hard words. Vladimir Zhirinovski, thank you for the interview.
My pleasure.